Ms. Fauzia, thank you for speaking with us here at the National Critics' Choice and the Policymaker Online News. Tell us more about what's happening in regards to policies for children and women. Are there benefits being created to support them?
Well, things have changed, of course. You cannot compare the current situation in Afghanistan to the Taliban regime, because during Taliban there was actually no government. Everything was collapsed. So after Taliban regime, we had to start everything from zero. And right now there are some progresses also when it comes to children. Like children go to school, I mean, that's the basic thing, and the government provides free education for children, for both boys and girls, and both boys and girls can go to school. But of course, because during the war, many people lost their male member of the family, children have to go to work on the streets to feed the family, and that is a problem. Also, Afghanistan is a country that many of the many of the young boys join the armed forces, militia groups. So they become child soldiers, and there have been so many programs to reintegrate ex-child soldiers back to the community, to reintegrate into the normal life, to provide jobs for them, to provide literacy programs for them. In the longer term, I think what is needed in Afghanistan is a social policy that could cover children's interests. There are laws that we also developed in the parliament. The law on there is a law that's called Juvenile Code. According to this law, of course, children will not be punished for the crime they commit. They will be put in rehabilitation centers. So there has been some progresses, but as I said before, the main problem is for children is job or I would say poverty and also health, because Afghanistan children are suffering from the highest mortality rate in the world. And also Afghanistan women are suffering from the highest maternal mortality in the world. These are long-term programs, but in the short term, there were programs to reintegrate the ex-child soldiers back to the community through literacy programs, through vocational training programs, through income generations and apprenticeship programs, and those programs were, I think, effective.
The biggest question right now to most investors outside Afghanistan is Afghanistan safe? Can they come into Afghanistan to provide investments, infrastructure, healthcare? I mean, you have already mentioned that healthcare is one of the most important things in Afghanistan. How safe Afghanistan is today right now?
It's a country in war, unfortunately. However, it is a country full of potential resources. Potential resources means it's a country full of mines, different kinds of mines. Afghanistan is naturally a very wealthy country. We have a very beautiful nature for tourism promotion. It's a mountainous and it's a beautiful country with a lot of water. It's a country that has a lot of mines underground, undeveloped mines. It's a country that has a lot of fruit, and it could be a reliable partner for the world. But unfortunately, because of security, those opportunities have not been used properly. I cannot say that security is not good all over the country. In some parts of the country, security is good in north, in northeast, in central highland, in the capital itself. I think it's a proper place for investment, especially in the mines and natural resources of Afghanistan, and on education and health as well. We need to have standard hospitals and standard universities to be able to compete with other parts of the world. And that, I think, needs investment from our international friends. And I think for that, Afghanistan is safe. I mean, terrorist acts, you never know. It may happen anywhere. A suicide bombing may happen anywhere in the world. You never know where it happened. But when it comes to structured insecurity, there is no structured insecurity. Bombing or a suicide attack may happen. I think it's a proper place. I think Afghanistan is a potential for investment in the world.
So, investment, security, and, of course, peace. Will there be peace in Afghanistan in the near future? Do you foresee Afghanistan able to partner with their neighbors like India and Pakistan? And what is your own perspective?
Yeah, there will be peace in Afghanistan if our neighbors are honest to us. Unfortunately, Afghanistan is located in a battlefield between Pakistan, India, Iran, United States. We are the victim of all this relationship, conflicting relationship. So I think, yes, we will be peaceful if our neighbors honestly participate in a peace process. Right now, their role is not very positive, especially Pakistan. Is not very positive in terms of bringing peace. They would like to control Afghanistan, and they would like to have a weak state in Afghanistan so that they could control and they could implement their own project, which is, from my perspective, wrong, because in a strong Afghanistan, they could partner, economically benefit, also socially. We have so many ties with Pakistan and Iran. But right now, they don't use that ties in the interest of both countries.
Well, last of all, what's next for you? I mean, now that you're the member of in the parliament, what will be your future programs from now to next few years for Pakistan?
In 2014. I will run as the president of Afghanistan in the election. I hope my messages, no matter if I win or if I don't win, I hope my messages will change the perspective of the individual, and I hope that Afghanistan people can only live in justice and security. These two have to go parallel with each other. You cannot have security without justice, because nowhere in the conflict countries, only security without ignoring justice could result. So I hope that one day Afghanistan will witness a female president.
Oh, thank you very much.
Thank you.